Hey guys, Potato Whiskey here, and welcome to Let's Play Civilization 6, Japan, on an island plates map. Now we are only playing on Emperor, as usual. This is just Emperor and Chill. You know, we played a few deity games, and then we're going to play an Emperor and Chill game, and then we'll go back into deity. So yeah, Emperor is just, I play on Emperor if I'm just, you know, feeling like I'm going to be Chill mode. Otherwise, I'll be playing on deity. Number of people living in your empire is truly impressive. Thank you very much. Okay, now this trade route is... there's some interesting choices here about where I send it to. I could go for gold here, and gold would be very useful. And there's not really much in the terms of plus yields here. So I think it may be an international one. Like, I could pick up plus one culture here from Fortizella, but there's also something to be said for having roads. I think picking up the culture and faith is actually pretty good here, because I don't have much, and it also helps me get currency. So, since we're about to pick up currency, I think it's time we started planning out the districts over here. Now, I would like the commercial district to be on the river, but I also want it to be beside the harbor, and I can't have both. Unfortunately, I can't have both, but it's fine. We're going to make some good decisions here, I feel. The first one we're going to make is that the harbor is actually not going to go for that adjacency bonus over here, because this would be... Well, maybe. Oh, it's hard to say. It is hard to say. If I went for... where would I put it? I think I would put my campus here. So that would be the campus there. It didn't save the settings. That would be the campus, okay. And this, that's okay, I'm happy with that campus location. And the harbor would be there in an ideal situation, just to make sure it's getting all its bonuses. Ah, it's not saving the thing. And then we would have another commerce here. In my opinion, would be pretty good. Well, those are the three main ones that I want to have planned out, which is fine. And now this city over here, you're going to want to think about yours. I think campus there makes sense. Let's see. Harbor, commerce, campus, yeah. So, harbor... commerce, campus. Trying to you know, utilize our adjacency bonus as much as possible and use up our tile. We're trying to use our tiles efficiently. We're trying to just play well. We're trying to play good. What tiles are you working? You do have an unimproved tile, which kind of bothers me. But we can't really improve that until we get lumber mills, which are pretty late in the game, actually, because a lot of the game happens in the early game. The most amount of turns. So we have a campus here, is a potential thing. We could also, we were wanting to build quadriremes and galleys. So I think we might actually stop off here and pick up a set. 7 turn galley seems like too much when we could pick up an encampment. See, I want to put my encampment on these tiles, but these tiles aren't grown to yet, which is a pain in my ass, so I'm gonna have to purchase them. Actually, that's actually a pretty cool encampment tile, so I think I will. Oh no, I'm not doing that yet. That's dumb. Let's just grab a 2 turns until we have a thing. So let's grab a granary here. We'll just put a few turns into a granary, and then we'll switch over to a commercial hub. Okay. You're working interesting tiles. We can't really do much about that over there. I would like to be building builders, but it's just not feasible at the moment to do so. Okay, so I think I spent a lot of time on this turn figuring out what I'm going to be doing. Which is fine. It's what long turns are for. Can you make your way actually over to the left here? That would be pretty useful to get more scouting done. I feel like we've scouted a lot of the map, and yet there's still a lot of the map left to scout. Okay. Library is not something I want to do so quickly, although he's getting 3 great scientist points per turn, which is crazy because, yeah, I really feel like the AI just feels like bullshit in this game. It really does. Here's the problem. The AI feels terrible at war, but it feels bullshit at like SimCity, which it just makes the game feel not good for me. I feel like I just have to go to war. I feel like I don't have a choice in how I want to play the game. We do need more settlers, but we also need galleys. We need a galley for the point, so I think we'll pick up that. And I think I've bounced back and forth with this guy a few times now, but hopefully I won't make that mistake again. I'm going to level you up to an archer. And you're going over where? I don't really have a good candidate for you to improve yet. What are you working on? 6 turns until there. Wait there for 6 turns. Shoot that guy. You're going to be defending across river, which is pretty good. We also have a galley. I'm going to scout up here a little bit, see if there's anything. It might be a city-state tucked in there. You never know. Although, they usually would send their units out, so it's probably not likely. We just finished the commerce hub tech. Now, the question is, do we finish this granary, or do we go straight for commerce hub? And I think we finished the granary. 25 turns. City isn't quite ready for a commerce hub. Now, we do have a few things we want to take care of here. Let's see here. This requires irrigation, so we are going to want to pick up irrigation eventually to be able to improve those. So I think we'll grab that. Oh, I did it again. Oh my god. My brain just needs to turn back on, I swear. Go here, because we want him to run that way, because he's easier to shoot that way. Skip turn. There's people arriving in my house because it is Wednesday, and that is time when we all meet up to have dinner. Okay, we're gonna scooch up here. Looks like there's a pathway to the north. We just finished the irrigation tech in one turn, which is pretty good. We will be going for this pretty early. But I think it's probably about time we started thinking about filling in some of these techs, like a wheel. An apprenticeship. So we're gonna set those up and then we'll think about what our next step is. Because we still have cities to settle. Let's kill this. Now he's truly stuck. And we should be able to hit here. You wait here a turn. You keep moving. Oh, looks like a spearman. Do a little bit of scouting. See if we can scout up here. Actually, what I will do is, can I send you on a multi-turn mission? We go there. Okay, ending the turn. We are producing a galley. Ooh, a little bit of damage. So we just finished games and recreation, which means we can change our policies. We are going to be producing settlers pretty soon here, so let's get that out of the way. In fact, let's do this. We're going to be dropping this, and I also want naval units, so I think we'll do this for now. We're going to want a galley and a quadrireme. I'm going to catch the scout. Catch the pigeon with scouts. That's the plan, at least. Okay. Go here. Box him in. Wait a turn. Oh, I need to get new blinds for my windows because my computer has a window right behind it, and as it's becoming summer, the sun likes to beam right in my face as I'm trying to record. So it's very inconvenient. I'll put it that way. You go over here. End the turn. We have a galley coming out, which will get us a thing with Mohandaro, and this galley can also go scout the world. And we're also going to be making a quadrireme 5 turns because there's another city state Brussels who wants us to have a quadrireme. We are going to be building commercial hubs, Amsterdam, so I will be putting two envoys inside you soon. We have finished, although that sounded like it wasn't what I said. The growth here is reasonable. Although it only saves one turn, so stick to that stuff. Now, you're going to probably do some stuff for me right now. You're going to pretty much beeline commercial hubs. Because you can't afford to build anything else. We'll go commercial hub here. You need a builder, but I don't have plus builder time. You're going to need also a granary to help you grow. I'm trying to get as much housing in as possible. Finally, I remember to go the right way. How many turns left? There's probably only a couple turns left. Yeah. So you're going to still wait there for the mine to come online. Move there. Go there. I'm trying to box in this scout to deal with him. Oh, we found this guy. This is someone I want to get a hold of. Construct a harbor. We are going to be constructing a harbor soon-ish, soon TM. And I do want the science, so I will send them an envoy. I know I'm being inefficient with the way I did that, but that's fine. Sometimes the wheels... Let's see. Doing a little bit of scouting. I still need more settlers, and I'm just not getting a chance to get them. I'm going to set this particular galley on auto-explore. And just because I don't want to manage it too much, it's starting to take up too much mental effort to remember what to do with my galleys. Okay. Yeah, I'm really upset that I haven't gotten enough settlers out. I need to finish this quadrireme. Maybe I'm making a mistake here, but I really want it. Crap, I need to purchase. Swap there. I want the harbor. Although you need to make me builders. That's a problem. I don't know. I'm making so many mistakes now because I'm getting flustered because I can't get my builders out. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm fine. Maybe I'm going to be okay. I just feel like I need to get more builders out or more settlers out. Oh, that was not supposed to be deleted. There's something weird going on here with the pins, because pins are changing and they're not the ones I've been clicking on. So, I don't know what to say to you there. Ooh, very cool. Little tiny piece of desert island. Maybe we'll settle on that. Not. Unit needs orders. Wait a turn. I'm gonna kill here. This is gonna be a major victory. Played correctly, that archer should win that fight, I think. You're gonna go here. In fact, you're gonna go scout up here. Oh my god, I have so many settlers I need to get out. I need to really hardcore just go for settlers after this quadrium. And there's this feeling of frustration. That's what I'm feeling. I'm feeling frustrated that things just don't happen the way I want them to in my games. I want to get settlers out, but I feel like I'm constrained by all these systems. And there's this really horrible dissonance that I don't like. Why don't you go auto-explore too? I think I'm going to put all my galleys on auto-explore. Because I think I've run out of mental capacity to manage them anymore in this game. Okay. It's not that it's annoying, it's that there's so much other stuff in my turns now that exploring, I don't have the mental resources to dedicate to properly managing my scouting units. So let's see here. You finished your granary, which means you're growing pretty aggressively. I am going to need a harbor. You also need a monument to grow your tiles. shoot here. You're going to take a bit of damage, but that's fine. Wait a turn, next turn. You head back up here. Oh, for God's sake. This is what I'm talking about. Like, these barbarians, they just appear and they are a thorn on your side. Oh, so maybe you're sending a settler out. Pretty far away, it looks like. If it's natural to kill. Okay, military training. Let's have a look here. So we aren't producing these anymore, so we can switch back in the builder production. And now we can start to think about long-term technologies. I think getting the builder stuff is good because we're on the way to it anyway. Sand Envoy. We aren't going to be building industrial hubs for a little while. We are building... I would like to build a harbor, but I'm just not in a position to do so. We'll shoot this guy. Move here. Why don't you level up, actually? We found Pio Patahi, which is a pretty... Actually, it's a pretty good place to settle a city, in my opinion. It's a really good natural wonder to spawn near. I didn't really get lucky with a natural wonder. I kind of spawned far away. I would like there to be maybe more natural wonders in the game and maybe put them in... I would like put natural wonders in between players so that there's something to fight over in the early game. That's what I would try and have my algorithm do, at least, if I were... designing it. Because really what you want from a game is for players to interact with each other. That's the most interesting part of a game, is when there's some sort of interaction, whether it's trading or things, and you want that to be the most interesting part of your game. So you want to work really hard to make things that make players interact and to make those interactions feel meaningful and interesting. Now we are going to be building a harbor here. Although I do need you to just literally just make builders for a while. Because I have one, two... I have like two cities that need builders, and then there's going to be another one that needs a builder. So, but you're just going to make builders for a little while. I'm going to send you over to Osaka. Pick this up. 60 faith. I could have used that a long, long, long time ago. I'm pretty upset that I didn't get it a long, long, long time ago. Because it probably would have given me, you know, a pretty good advantage in the early game. We found the Galapagos. Yeah, like, I don't like this when it's... This feels like this is wasted, you know, because it's on a city-state's land. And who cares about a city-state, you know? Why is it there? It doesn't need to be there. Okay, we have a Pantheon. This doesn't really particularly matter. Although a fishing boat production is a reasonable one, in my opinion. We'll go here. Still trying to push away. You're going to go there. Get that last little bit of scouting down here. Pick this up. Ugh. Just scouts coming out of everywhere. We are about to get another settler out, and we will be able to get these cities settled pretty soon, actually. Could I purchase a settler? No, they're really expensive. There's a scout down here. Pick this up. A little bit of gold. Not sure what I'm going to use my gold for. There is some purchases I could do. Shoot there. Okay, we're in the medieval era, so we just picked up some new city-state quests. The first one is recruit a great merchant. That's something I would like to do. Trigger Yuriki for education. What is education? What is education? I'm not going to get that one. This is just basically... Get lucky or get a great scientist. This is... I don't want to construct the holy site. Theology? No, not going to get that one. Theater Square? Nah. All these kind of suck and I don't care about them. So let's choose a little bit of research here. I think it's time. We hit the medieval era. We're not quite ready for that. I think we do pick up lumber mills here. Because there's probably a few lumber mills in my empire. You're going to go up there. More settlers. I don't have anything I really need. I could get a little bit of science out of this guy. What do you give me? Geneva bonus. Yeah, think I'll pick that up, become their envoy or their suzerain, get the 15% science. That's a pretty good bonus in my opinion. Kill there. It might actually be one of the best city-state bonuses, the Geneva one. Although it is easy just for someone to declare war on you to deny you it. If they don't want to envoy fight you. You still get the bonuses from it and they lose. You know, so there's interaction there based on what players will do. Okay, so I have one going over here. I want another one going over here. We're also going to need another builder for up here. You're going to fortify until healed. Okay, let's have a little bit of luck here. Did we already get masonry? So, building a quarry, I don't think that's worth it at this stage in the game. So what tiles are you working? I think it does make sense to get a farm there though. And let's see. They do a little bit of exploring. Keep our city safe from the bad people. Got a monument finishing up here, so this city's tiles should start growing much quicker. Okay, so now I feel I need to get these commercial hubs, but you're not growing to the right tiles for me to do that, so I think I'll grab a campus on you. Grab a campus. You've got a builder on the way, so why don't you grab me a harbor? Starting to build districts in our cities. How many farms have I got? I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six. I think I will drop this for the feudalism boost. Oh, I accidentally used the settler's movement. It's not a big deal, but slight inefficiency of my play. Although I don't think it would have affected it because it can't move there anyway. And this time I'm going to try something different with my trade routes. I'm going to try and send them outwards from my capital. Although, no, that doesn't seem very good. Maybe I'll send them outwards and then flip them. We'll see what we do. Go there. I know we improved that, but it doesn't really help us much. And then get the bananas. So you already have plus one housing. Now get this online. I guess it is worth it because it is a production-ish tile. It turns it into like a bad hill, basically. Although they're so garbage, I may as well harvest it. We'll see. I think for now, I'll stick it on it. Because it's better than the desert tiles. And I don't have a district planned for it. So let's just drop a quarry on it. That'll make the tile, you know, barely better. Just fortify there until the settler gets there. Scout around. You go on to alert. Okay, we have another settler coming out. This one's going to go here, here. Defense is superior. Okay, we've almost finished settling, actually. We're getting pretty close. I think that was part of the frustration, is we were really close to finishing our settling. Okay, you finish your commerce hub. So now you make your trader. And you're going to send that to Kyoto. So Mary is pretty far ahead in science right now. Okay. We finished another settler. So we have a settler going over there, going over there. I think I'm going to send it over here now because it's really far away. We want to settle the furthest cities away first. That might seem counterproductive, but it'll make sure our cities are closer together in their development. Okay. So you have a builder. This guy has used up its builder. There's a builder coming over here. So I guess we delay for a few turns on a builder. And you should pick up me a harbor now. Or a commercial hub. Grab the harbor first. Now, go for a quick... Let's see, what do you do? What do you do with this builder if you were me? We're going for... lumber mills, machinery. This city has some pretty rough tiles going on over here. This city down here is going to need a builder. So we're going to hold off on this builder until we finish feudalism, and then we'll make more builders. So we have one, two, three. So one more settler after this, and we're finished settling for the foreseeable future at least. Make your way over there. We do have a trader coming out pretty soon. Is this on quick speed or is it on standard? I don't remember. It's on standard speed. Well, I haven't actually played many standard speed games. Now, it's telling me to settle there. But this, in my opinion, is clearly better. It does miss out on the spices for a long time. But this is just better, in my opinion. Okay, a little bit of an awkward moment there as my family all arrived. I'm going to try and finish up this episode, though. Let's see here. We have a builder here who has no moves left. I think we will improve that mine. We'll end the turn. Actually, yeah, we'll do one more turn and then I'll end the video. Sorry about that. I have a very awkward recording schedule right now. So it doesn't work in my favor. With the advance of feudalism. Okay, we're going to drop a mine here. We're going to choose a civic. Kill the unit with a quadrarium. We're not going to get that. So we have mid-feudalism. So now what's our... I think picking up civil service is pretty good. Although I think we just go straight for exploration to get the better government that we want. Okay, you've made a trader. And I'm going to send this actually to my capital city, Kyoto, because Kyoto needs a bit of help. You're not growth restricted at the moment. You just don't have very good tiles. You... could use a builder, but not really, because we don't have a lumber mill. I will be putting a lumber mill there. I think we'll... Although the city could use some growth. I don't think a market here helps me too much. I think actually a harbor is the dream, right? Yeah, grab a harbor. Like, what does this say, harbor? They should say campus. Oh, I don't know. Okay, so that's a campus. And we're going to be picking up something here. Unit maintenance is probably a good choice here. Or newly trained builders gain 2 extra build actions. And then we'll build some builders in a few turns. Why don't you go there? You head over there. Okay, we have a settler in place. We have a builder coming up this way. Everything has its limits. So what tiles are you working? Okay, you're working that. Once we finish this turn, we'll end the video. So I'm going to send you over to... I could pick up a lot of gold here, but I think picking up the production would be pretty good for Kyoto, because Kyoto needs some help. It has been building settlers for so long that it's suffering. It's suffering just a little bit. Okay, I don't think I'm going to put a pasture there quite yet. 10 turns until our thing is done. So... I think it might be a good idea to actually quick purchase an archer here. Or build one. How many turns? 3 turns. What if I purchased an archer? Yeah, I think I'll purchase it for 200 to get that boost. That's fine. And go get that fish online. And that's going to be the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you in the next video. If you want to see more of this, please remember to subscribe to my channel. And if you want to... directly support my channel, please leave a like on the video as it helps my ranking on YouTube. If you want to give me feedback about this episode, please leave a comment. But that's pretty much it. That's the call to action, so to speak. Thank you very much for watching. Bye bye. See ya.